Hello everybody, welcome back to Let's Play Kingdom Hearts. This is Kevin, and today, as you can see, Sora knows how to block. Thank God. So yes, as I said before, I got to level 12, and the reason I wanted to do that is to learn two very important skills. Now, if you picked up a shield, you'd learn these two skills. If you picked up any of the other two weapons, the sword or the scepter, you would have learned two different skills. Guard and Scan. Guard you learn at level 9, Scan at level 12. The reason I wanted to get Scan is to show you how much health each of the characters that you fight on Destiny Island here have. Doesn't sound too awkward of a sentence. Anyway, so yes. First off, let's go back to Riku. Now, as I said before, this is a different file because I won against Riku on this file and I'm very OCD. Because I do not like to lose against Riku. Now, as you can see, he will always begin with that kind of movement to jump behind you and hit you. Now that I have block, I won't be getting hit by as many of his attacks. Definitely not. A lot of his attacks that are blockable are just, you know, I'm going to be blocking them. So yeah, block is a very handy skill to have. Reason being, as it is like a full frontal barrier. Anything that can hit you from the front will be blocked. You know, you won't take any damage, and sometimes you'll even get experience for it, as you see. So yeah. Now the thing about his kick? That was close. Anyway, the thing about his kick, sometimes you'll have a chance to block it. If you complete your combo. I'll show you here in a little bit, if ever I can get him to do it. As you can see there, I completed my combo, and Sora kind of edged past him to the point where he did his kick, and I avoided it just narrowly. I happen to remember, for whatever reason, that happens quite a bit. At least when I was doing it on my practice file. So, for whatever reason, just didn't seem to happen this time. So anyway, as you can see, we beat Riku this time. Last time. Anyway, and for beating Riku, you get a potion. Yes. So, now that we've done that... Oh, also he gets 5 experience, but that's not that big a deal. Titus is still the best character to train against, regardless of anything. So, anyway, speaking of Titus, now that we've beaten Riku, we are going to go and face Titus, Selphie, and Waka, all three against Sora at the same time. So, yeah. Now that I feel like we're ready, let's do it. So, my strategy for this is to use Waka's ball to stun Titus and Waka himself, and then effectively I'm going to take out Selphie since she is the only one left able to fight. Plus, just in case you're wondering, Waka's ball cannot stun Selphie, though it will damage her, as you can see. Now, Selphie is almost taken out, just one more hit. Move out of my way, Titus. Hit. And okay, so Titus got a lucky hit there, but that's not a big deal. Now, I want to stun Waka if I can. Or I can stun... Nope. Okay. You know what? Here we go. I can actually see. Stun him. There we go. And let's take Waka out. Because frankly, it's no fun taking out Titus second anyway. As I said before, it's pretty simple. To do this fight, the biggest premises is using Waka's Blitz Ball to stun Titus and Waka himself, and then just taking Selphie out first. And then you can actually choose who you want to take out second between Waka and Titus. As I said, I do prefer to take out Titus last, but you know, it's not that big a deal, really. It's not a big difference. You can get experience this way as well if you want to just sit here and grind against Titus, but I don't have to do that because I already did that. I can't believe we lost. Now, for defeating all three of them, you get a potion! Yes. So, as you can see, I have 2 potions here already. Let's see here, and I have 2 in my inventory, along with the 2 logs, the cloth, and the rope. Now, in order to equip potions, yes, I know you actually have to equip them, you have to, go to item. You can either use exchange or take out. I just happen to be used to using exchange, so that's what I use there, but if you want to use take out, you can. Takeout's always nice. Some nice Chinese food. Anyway, so we're done for the first day. So now it's time to go and oh wait a second. No, we're not done yet. No. I have some plans here. I almost forgot. What I actually want to do is I want to fight Riku 3 more times and win 3 more potions from him. This is very important, so I will be right back. Okay, and we're back. So I beat Riku 3 more times. Here's the proof. I have 3 potions. And here's the potions that I equipped before. I haven't used any. So yeah, it's pretty simple to beat him after you gain Scan and Guard, especially Guard. Guard is such a good skill to have. It's primarily a skill that you have to learn to use against bosses if you want to kind of have the edge. So getting it early on and learning to use it is very advisable. So for getting everything on the first day and not talking to Kairi and asking her where to get everything, you get a high potion. You can either choose to stay on the first day and do whatever you need to, or move on, as we're going to here. So it's cutscene time.
So, Kairi's home is out there somewhere, right?
Could be. We'll never know by staying here.
But how far could a raft take us?
Who knows? If we have to, we'll think of something else.
So, suppose you get to another world. What would you do there?
Well, I haven't really thought about it. It's just, I've always wondered why we're here, on this island. If there are any other worlds out there, why did we end up on this one? And suppose there are other worlds. Then ours is just a little piece of something much greater. So, we could have just as easily ended up somewhere else, right?
I don't know.
Exactly. That's why we need to go out there and find out. Just sitting here won't change a thing. It's the same old stuff. So let's go.
You've been thinking a lot lately, haven't you?
Thanks to you. If you hadn't come here, I probably would have never thought of any of this. Kairi, thanks.
You're welcome.
Sora! You wanted one, didn't you?
A Paopu fruit?
If two people share one, their destinies become intertwined. They'll remain a part of each other's lives, no matter what. Come on, I know you want to try it.
What are you talking?